Oh, Thank you. Let me tell you something here this morning. We have to be grateful for the fact that we get that testimony from that young man here this morning. Because like, we are young men sitting here. We are young men sitting here. And we don't want them to experience that life.
Amen.
So that they hear it from somebody who experienced that life and who Christ said.
Amen.
You understand what I'm saying? So bless the Lord. And bless the Lord for this morning. We bless the Lord for your life, for all what you've been through. We thank him for you right now. Amen. Hallelujah. You see, the thing about it is we had to understand the whole reason for the corporate body, you know. We had to understand that in the corporate body, there is so much power and anointing in the fellowship of the saints when we come together. You know, the other night, I remember Sister Annie was telling them that we're not clapping. You know, and we not giving God enough. When we clap, it's a kind of halfway clap. You know, and when we clap and when we make a noise, we shaking the enemy. We shaking down their pants. You see, this cause a rumble to take place. So anytime you're silent, it's because you're silent for your own deliverance and you're silent for your own breakthrough. You're silent to be pointing at the Lord loud. You need to make a louder noise than me. So make the noise when they get the opportunity to make the noise. Something, because once you ain't participating, then you're not in agreement.
Amen.
You're not in agreement. The whole thing is about being in agreement.
Amen.
The Bible says that they came together in one accord, you know.
Amen.
One accord. So when the word comes true, everybody in agreement say amen.
Amen.
Yes. Hallelujah. We destroy the enemy plan. You're looking for healing. You're looking for breakthrough. So we gotta be here when we hear amen.
Amen.
Through the door, be here. Wherever you was before you come through them doors, leave it right there.
Amen.
Don't come inside here with it and act like you're still with you, because Jesus in here and the blood saturated in the atmosphere and the Holy Ghost moving through this place. Loose it in the name of Jesus. We're gonna bring loose from you. Whatever you was experiencing during the week, we loose it from you right now in Jesus' name. Amen.
Yes.
Whatever burden you was on that trial you was facing, we loose it from you in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Yes.
Whatever trial you was dealing with your finances, we loose it from you in the name of Jesus. Say it.
Yes.
Anytime you come in here, we don't make the gospel already. You're in a battle. Let me tell you something. Believers in Christ Jesus, you're in a battle out there as a believer in Christ. But you're in a battle to be won. You're not in a battle for defeat. You're in a battle to show the enemy how to win. Amen. Don't get kicked today, amen.
Amen.
Don't get tired with the corporate body. When we come together to defeat plans.
Amen.
We come together to break chains.
Yeah.
We come together to call healing.
Yeah.
We come together to cause finances to come true and increase.
Yeah.
We come together for multiplication, increase, completion.
Yeah.
That's what we come here for. Yeah. We come here to serve Christ. Hallelujah. God is a mighty God.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Because let me tell you, it has so many things to be thankful for.
Yes.
So many things to be thankful for. I was coming to give a testimony earlier. Patience. Don't take the opportunity. Don't think that it will be alright for a second or a minute. It takes less than that for you to die.
Amen.
Less than that for you to die. So I just want you all to be conscious of who we are in Christ Jesus this morning. Keep praying, keep praising, keep believing, and keep pleading the blood over your children.
Amen.
Plead the blood over your families.
Yeah.
Plead the blood over your house.
Yeah.
Plead it over your journeys.
Yeah.
You hear, take the opportunity. Take the opportunity. Man, I went down my son with the blood Sunday this week on the phone with him, and I said, blood, blood, blood. I said, say it too, you know.
Yeah.
Blood. Wet them down with the blood.
Amen.
Saturate them with the blood. saturate them with the blood. You believe?
Amen.
You have faith?
Amen.
Blood in the atmosphere.
Amen.
Jesus' blood over this environment, over your journeys, over your lives and finances. His blood, and his one blood, Jesus' blood.
Amen.
That's the blood that has covered all things, amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. So I give God praise in all things, and as I tell you, you got to thank him for every situation. Every situation, because somewhere, somebody going to meet Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You hear what I'm telling you? Somewhere, somebody is going to meet Jesus Christ. Somewhere, somebody met Jesus Christ within all the incidents and the situations that are taking place. And the important thing is that person who met Jesus going to heaven. That person saved from hell. If you are coming from the sufficient sacrifice. So talk about it to people, you know, tell people about this Jesus is serving you.
Amen.
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 Turn your books to Matthew. Chapter 27. We're just looking at 27 and 28 this morning briefly. Because I don't want you all to be oversaturated. I think that you all have been saturated this morning. The Sunday school was awesome. Give it up for Sister Sinead, Minister Sinead. It was awesome. And I want to urge you guys to get here early, not to miss it. Please. Right, it's in your best interest to get here on time, not to miss it. You're looking from verses 55, chapter 27, verse 55. Right, and then we're just going over to 28 right here to examine a few verses from verses 1 to 10. Right, try to get here early. Right, the testimony of this young brother Richard here too was awesome. And his understanding of the sufficiency of Christ and the cross, it was awesome, my young brother. Thank you for that. Right? The worship was awesome. Amen. And just being in your presence is an awesome thing to me. Hallelujah. I give God praise for you guys. Amen. Thanks for somebody who clapped there. Amen. Don't play clapping too much now. After the fact. We love you still. Amen. Yesterday was the women's ministry. What do women in the house say? Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Say amen.
Amen.
Yeah. Yesterday was the women's ministry. And I heard that they had an awesome time.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
I heard it was runway business here. They made some outfits out of Guardian people. I hear it was a real nice time. You know, I saw some pictures, I saw the women having all that awesome fun and thing, you know. It was a good time to meet every women.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Yes. You know? So you know, thanks for that too. You know, we prayed about that too before it happened. So you know, thanks for letting and stuff pull off as it was. I know to me, you know, every time I see women and them do the thing on a Saturday, I think them supposed to just have their way for the rest of the year. The whole thing, they supposed to just control today too. You know what I mean?
That's what I would rather,
you know, that they just do the whole thing now. They come with the anointing from yesterday and just do the whole thing now. Today they being supposed to do that, they just handling everything. You know? Yeah, just let it run over. Like what Sister Alison said, just let it run over. We give God thanks and praise for Sister Alison. This leading this worship every Sunday morning. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah. So we in Matthew 27, I want to look at verse 55. I don't know, a couple of you all might just get the gist of this as soon as I start to speak because you've been following the devotions. As well as some of you are going to be very lost because you're not following the devotions. I hear no amen to that. Don't feel bad. It's late. Late. Right. Matthew 27, verse 55. And we're just going to verse 61. And it says this. And many women would there be holding a flower which followed Jesus from Galilee, ministering unto him. Among which was Mary Magdalene, and Mary the mother of James and Joseph, and the mother of Zebedee's children. When the evening was come, there came a rich man of Arimathea named Joseph, who also himself was Jesus' disciple. He went to Pilate and begged the body of Jesus. Then Pilate commanded the body to be delivered. And when Joseph had taken the body, he wrapped it in a clean linen cloth and laid it in his own new tomb, which he had hewn up in the rock. And he rolled a great stone to the door of the sepulcher and departed. And there was Mary Magdalene and the other Mary sitting over against the sepulcher. Father, we give you thanks and praise for your reading. And thank you, Lord God, for your word that's about to come over and the atmosphere that takes place to serve the Lord God. And we ask you that it would be appropriate and applicable in all the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Right? I want you to, as I said, that rollover thing that you remember, you know? So I want to kind of keep talking that you remember this morning. Is that right? Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Thing. Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah. I want you to see something with women. Women, 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 women. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible saying that they followed Jesus from the beginning of the trial and the journey to the cross until Jesus hung on the cross. They watched Jesus die on the cross. They watched Jesus be buried in the tomb. And they were the last to leave after he was buried. The women. The women were there, all by the men dispersed and around. And the Bible reminds us that these women ministered unto Jesus Christ. So while Jesus was on this journey, and he may have been battered and beaten, they were still trying to get a little sip of water to him. They were still trying to be of service to him. It didn't stop none of the women. The women followed the Bible, say, from afar off. They kept there, despite the dangers that surrounded him. They were there with Jesus from the beginning of the trial to the end period, where they closed the tomb and they rolled the stone in front of the door. They said that Mary was sitting down on the next side, watching that tomb close up in on that day. That's women.
Yes.
All what the men run from.
Yes.
The women stayed to endure and look at.
Amen.
They watched the flesh tear off. The men ran from the time they come in the Garden of Gethsemane. From the time they put hands on Jesus Christ, they said they dispersed him. They scattered him. Peter and them went to the synagogue. Jesus told him, he said, all the chat you gave me about you going and do this and that. He said, before the cock crow, you gone too. Peter said, nay, Lord, I will die with you. By the time the cock crow, Peter was panting too. But the women was right there, they never moved. Amen. 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 There's some clapping because the women never moved. I want you to understand the seriousness of the woman today in your life. And the women who bring you up, they don't just move just like that. They don't shift just like that. They're there for the trial. They're there for the situation. They're there for when you're wounded. They're there to see you through it. That's the woman. The woman in Christ is a serious woman and a strong woman and a ministering woman.
Amen.
A ministering woman means she's a serving woman.
Yes.
You hear what I'm saying? In the book of Luke chapter 8, it tells us about two more women again. I always like to tell people about that. Joanna and Susanna, the Bible call them in Luke chapter 8 verse 3. They said they ministered. First thing I tell you is Herod's wife, Joseph's Stuart's wife, and she ministered unto Jesus Christ. And the women never left Jesus alone. It was always an undying love for him. Just a servant and to be in his presence. That's the woman. And that's with purpose, with real purpose. You have a genuine purpose. Because they ain't looking out for nothing, you know. They just truly want to serve Christ.
Yeah.
You feel welcome in? And because they just truly want to serve Christ, you don't treat you like Solomon. I say, you didn't ask you, you're going and receive.
Yeah.
You didn't ask for that healing, you're going and receive.
Yeah.
You didn't ask for that deliverance, you're going and receive.
Yeah.
You say, you didn't ask for the breakthrough, you say, receive it.
Yeah.
You become just because you want to serve Christ. In all the truth and in You ain't come looking for something. You come looking for Jesus. You come looking to serve Jesus as a woman in Christ Jesus. Why don't you give praise to them women and them? You guys just know, no. Man is the head. Man still come from a woman. You feel where I'm coming from?
Yes.
So to make you a head of woman, and to make you too. I want to have some men here today. Amen. To make you a head, the woman had to make you too. And I ain't just talking about childhood. I'm talking about she could make you into a real man. Like you again. I tried to encourage women and children. And I want the men now to really, really understand the gem and the priceless people that God put in your lives now. You understand what I'm saying? I would never ever chain you up this morning to love your woman more. I would never ever chain you up this morning to love your wife more. Eh? I would never ever do that this morning, amen? And if you're quoting, you know what I'm telling you, people just say quoting. I would never can quote better. Do something more. If you're not going into the thing, you're not in the game, you're not trying. Quote better. You know, make a better move than we're making, because a woman is an important, let me tell you something, a woman in Christ Jesus is an important piece of pillar to build on. You can't build without a woman. You hear what I'm saying here today? You cannot build without a woman. I'm telling you, all while Jesus' disciples running, they can't find them. Them woman and them following so, and they're not moving. They just going to the right place. They watch the tomb close. So let's look at Matthew 28 from verse 1 here, quick, right? From verse 1. And it says, in the end of the Sabbath, as it began to dawn towards the first day of the week, came Mary Magdalene and the other Mary to see the sepulchre. So they reached before morning. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone from the door and sat upon it. Just as day was the last to see it close, the women and them was the first to see the tomb open. You hear what I'm saying? They were the first to see the tomb. They were the first to see that angelic occurrence, because it's an angel, the Bible said, come down from heaven. You can imagine what I'm telling you about. The angel come down from heaven and roll back the stone at the tomb where Jesus Christ was. And you hear what the Bible telling you? And these women watching this thing. You feel, let me tell you something. I feel a man might have run, but a woman started to take it in. You know what I'm saying? Because they stand up, they watch the whole trial. So they, God, you feel God has made mistakes? Who think God has made mistakes here? Yeah? It ain't no mistake that it's two women see it first. It ain't no mistake that it's two women, the angel. Wait, let's go. Verse 2 says, and behold, there was a great earthquake, for the angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone in the door, and he sat upon it. So we know the kind of angel that's with the Lord here, right? His countenance was like lightning, and his raiment was like snow. So the man literally sparkling and looking like shock coming out of him as he sits there on top of this stone. And for fear, here the first two men here we see here right now. And for fear of him, the keepers did shake and became as dead men. The two men, the men were guarding the tomb. The men were guarding the tomb. The Bible said that for fear they started to shake. And they became as dead men. And the women were to know what is going on. You hear what I'm saying? What frightened the man, and frightened the woman at all. They frightened for certain things, and the woman signed up brave. They studied how we going to deal with this week coming up here, and the woman said, don't worry about that. They going to get food. They studied how we paying our bills this week, and the woman said, you don't worry about that. We going to pay them bills. You hear, that's the woman now. You understand what I'm saying? What frightened the man? The woman getting more encouraged to encourage the same men. You get what I'm telling you? So give thanks for the women and them in your life. Women and them in your life, they may hear by mistake. And the woman who God put in your life, ain't no mistake neither. I hear the men at all. I hear the men at all. The women that God put in their life, ain't no mistake that he put 10 women in their life neither, man.
Amen.
I'm not sure when this is like a God. It's when they're supposed to hold them all in. Right? Yes, they are. Yes, they are. Verse 5. And the angel answered and said unto the women, fear not ye. So the new friend. For I know that ye seek Jesus, which was crucified. He is not here. For he is risen, as he said, come see the place where the Lord lived. You hear the invitation? Let me tell you something. We all know the gospel is the death, the burial, and the resurrection. The women were the first to receive the completed confirmation of the gospel by an angelic being. You hear what I'm telling you? The first person to hear that the death, the burial, and the resurrection had been completed was the women that were by the tomb. First. So they reached first. They was first. They get the news first, and they get encouraged first.
Amen.
Women. Women, women, women.
Yes.
You hear what I'm telling you about this? So he tell them, only don't worry, you know. Don't study them fellas and then. Them fellas still shaking. You know, why the angel didn't tell them don't worry? He tell the women, he said, only don't worry. He said, who he was looking for, he done rise already. Because the women went to the tomb that day in anticipation of seeing Jesus Christ alive.
Amen.
You hear what I'm telling you this morning? They didn't go there looking for no dead Christ, you know.
Amen.
The women went there in anticipation of meeting Jesus, sign up to what's in them, and said, come in. That's women, you know. They have that anticipation, and that anticipation is a winning thing, and is a winning tool as a woman, you know. They could anticipate something. You understand what I'm saying? They can anticipate when it's wrong, and they can anticipate when it's right.
Amen.
Listen to you, one of them this week. Yeah. Yeah. You men say amen?
Yeah.
Like, you ever want to agree with that? So, verses 8 now. You just going to 10. No, verses 9. And he says this. He says, 7. And go quickly and tell his disciples. And behold, he going before you into Galilee. There shall ye see him. Lo, I have told you. And they departed quickly from the sepulchre with fear and great joy, and did run to bring his disciples word. They send the women and their... Listen, we just be thinking something. It's the women who get the message first to go and preach the gospel. Is the women collected by the tomb and tell them, go and tell them what that Jesus Christ raised from the dead? You know? Is the women getting message to them first? You know? He said, go quickly and tell the disciples, not the disciples together, the women who was by the tomb who get the message first, to go and tell them that Christ raised from the dead. Is it women? I want everyone women to understand who you are in Christ Jesus.
Yes.
You feel so?
Yes.
Eh? They were quick with the word, you know. A woman ought to be quick with the word, you know, and excited to tell somebody about Jesus Christ. And you know, I'm telling you that the women will tell more people than the men.
Amen.
The women ain't have no problem with telling about Jesus Christ, you know. Because there's a quickness and an excitement that God put inside of you, you know, to burn that fire, you know, and tell somebody on your job about Jesus.
Yes.
And tell somebody when you're traveling about Jesus.
Yes.
And when you're in the hospital, the first thing you go and say is, well, they know Jesus.
Yes.
That's the woman. You understand? There's a quickness and an excitement, but they were the first to go and preach the gospel. Is that anybody who says so?
Amen.
They were the first to go and preach the gospel, and they went to preach it to the men. They want to tell them, and now if you go straight on into this chapter, you would see by the time these women do tell the men, the Bible says that some of them doubted. When they do get to the disciples, the Bible says when these women went and tell them that Jesus Christ, they say, hey, Jesus ain't in tomb no more, and Jesus raised him in there. The Bible says that some of the men doubted. Doubted, but not the women. They didn't doubt at all. because they didn't see Christ in the tomb, and they believed that he was from the dead. You hear what I'm saying? And they went to the newsman. Not maybe, you know, they went and tell them that he is risen. They didn't go with them and say that we think he ain't there, you know. They went and said Jesus Christ raised from the dead. So here was happening. So verse 6 says that they departed quickly from the sepulchre with fear and great joy, and did run to bring his disciples word. Now hear this. Look at verse 9. It says, and as they went to tell his disciples, behold, the Bible says, look who reached. Jesus. Jesus met them. They ever said,
yes.
The Bible said, Jesus met them, saying, all hail. This Jesus is something. Say, all hail. That's like a real cool man slang in that stand up in the room. All hail. That was the scene. And they came and held him by the feet and worship him. Yeah. But you hear what he meant? So that's why we worship on a Sunday. Reason why the New Testament Church in Christ Jesus worships on a Sunday is because it's the first day that worship went to the resurrected Christ. If you didn't know why we just come on a Sunday morning, that's the reason. Alright? So they worshiped him and held him by his feet. And then it said that Jesus said to them, be not afraid. Go tell my brethren that they go into Galilee, and there shall they see me. So now instead of the message they get about Jesus, they get the message from Jesus. You hear what I'm saying?
Amen.
Let me tell you something about the women. Amen. Listen. Listen, we're wrapping up here this morning, right? Time to worship, amen.
Right.
I hear you, man. What do you want to worship?
Yes.
What do you want to worship?
Yes.
Yeah, we have to worship this morning because it's Sunday morning. Amen?
Amen.
Don't let this on body's ribbon, huh? Just let this. They was the first to reach the tomb. They was the first to witness. They was the first to hear and to speak the gospel in completion. After when it was completed. Only time everybody talking it before, but it wasn't ready. You see, when you speak it after completion, which means somebody can get saved at that point in time. Before the women and them spoke the gospel, they didn't have nobody saved. Everybody was still in limbo. You hear what I'm telling you? It's when the women and them spoke the gospel that day, some men get saved and some men was doubting. You understand what I'm telling you? It's the women who brought the gospel and salvation to the world first. As they preach the word first, as they tell people about Christ raising from the dead first. You hear what I'm telling you? That's who the woman is. And hear what? They were the first to worship. They were the first to worship Jesus Christ at that point in time. On the first day of the week. Women, I just want to encourage you this morning. Right? I want to encourage you all, as the Bible says, to be without fear. As you traverse this week, as you leave here today, any things that you say, any things that you do, and where you go, do it without fear. Be encouraged, and women encourage the other women.
Amen.
Encourage your sisters. Touch them and tell them, look, everything will be all right and okay because we know Jesus.
Amen.
Encourage your sisters. Continue to pray for your sisters. Continue to encourage the men in your lives. Your sons, who you're bringing up. Your nephews, who you had to talk to. The husbands that you have. The uncles, all the men, you have a responsibility to carry Jesus to them.
Amen.
You hear what I'm saying? And don't be afraid to carry Jesus to them. Because when you carry Jesus to them, what you carry to them is a breakthrough in the atmosphere. What I'm telling you here this week is that you all have to change lives. You get what I'm telling you? And change how things go in people's atmospheres. You had to change that. The women. Because as you get the responsibility to go and do it first.
Amen.
Go and do it. Step out there here today and go and speak the word of God. Tell people about Jesus raised from the dead. Change lives. Tell them about all the deliverance that could take place because Jesus Christ is a miracle working God. Yeah. A big, big God. I'm going to meet you. Listen, I'm not coming this morning. And he said, where Jesus Christ meets him, Jesus Christ will meet you at the point of your need. You get what I'm telling you today? Jesus Christ, once you have that excitement and fire for Christ Jesus, and you know, listen, Jesus Christ coming to meet you in the way. You understand what I'm telling you? Be ready to meet him. All the journeys that you had to go on, Jesus Christ done standing up in the way already to meet you, to encourage you to continue the journey. No journey ain't done. You get what I'm telling you? No journey ain't complete. Don't feel that you drop short by any plan that the enemy executes. You hear what I'm telling you? Jesus Christ is about to meet you on the way. Yeah, you hear what Jesus is doing? Once you move in for Christ Jesus, he come in the way and meet you, and Jesus Christ is going to allow you to worship. So worship and break through the atmosphere. And when you see you worshiping Jesus, Jesus presents himself physically for your touch. You hear what I'm hearing this morning? So get ready to physically have an interaction with Christ Jesus this week. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody give God praise, man.